everyone, this is Lisa from K9 Clips Dog Grooming Tips, and this is Larry, and Larry is a Lhasa Apso, and he's come in for his full groom today, and I'm going to show you that, all without any restraints, and in just under 1 hour here. So hopefully you enjoy the video. So with all the dogs that I groom, I don't use any restraints, and I never have used any restraints, and all my videos show you that. Even with the difficult dogs. And I do not edit any of my video, so what you see is what I do. So you get the full groom when I on all my videos. So right now I'm going to use a number 5 on him. He's got a little bit thicker fur, as it's that time of year here where it's colder out, so everyone lets their dogs grow out a bit longer. So when they do come in for their groom, they have a little bit of mass. And we're still into winter right now. Probably got another month or, well, a couple months actually. So in the springtime, after that comes, after it starts to melt and get the nice weather, then I really, you'll see lots of matted dogs come in. And very overgrown dogs. It's just all the owners, including myself, tend to grow their dogs out a little bit to keep them a little bit warmer, but then they can get a little bit matted, so depending on the breed, of course. You can see there's some matting there. Larry's been coming to me for many years now. And you can see he's still a little bit nervous. And that's not uncommon for a dog not to enjoy coming to the groomer. So I'm going to come back with a different clipper inside of there. Just comes with, it's a sensitive area, and I do want to get it a little bit closer as well. And I can tell the blade is just starting to get warm. So I'm going to switch that out.
Thank you.
paint. Oh boy. Okay, so it's starting to get a little warm again. It's always good to check your blades. If you are grooming your dog, make sure they don't get too warm on the babies. Okay, where the heck I'm playing. Oh dear. Oh no. I slither away. You stinker. Okay, come on. Oh, it's okay. Hold on. There you go. It's okay. It's okay.
Thank you.
switch them out one more time here. And then I'm going to switch to a shorter blade just to do underneath his more delicate areas. But also those areas are more prone to matting and or stuff sticking in that area. So I like to do that a bit shorter as well. So I'm going to switch to number 7 now. Mm-hmm. All right, we'll get him to stand up. Come on up. Up, up, up. Good boy. There's a little bit of matting in there just where he pees, so it kind of gets a little sticky and then mats around that area. So I'm actually going to be doing that even shorter with a number 10. I'm going to switch to that one now. Okay. I'll get you a video of that. Okay, so now I'm going to work on the feet. Work my way around. This just takes all the bulk off him. So when I give him a bath, I can get him nice and clean. And then I do finish up with another trim after again with the clippers. But now that we got that bulk off and all the mats, I like to use the scissors. So I do use scissors to trim the feet, where most groomers use clippers. I prefer the scissors. Change your sight on, buddy. Now you want it to up. Just don't want you right at the end. Right in there, right? Okay. Just pulling away a little bit with his foot there. this one. A little bit of matting in there. And I do have some videos of me using clippers versus scissors. I just seem to find that the dogs are more relaxed with the scissors rather than the vibration of the clippers in there. And I have been using scissors since the very beginning of when I started 16 years ago, so of course I'm more comfortable with them. So if you want to see, you can check out those videos if you'd like to see the comparison. I have labeled them and put them in categories as well for training. And it'll be where the trimming the feet category is, or nails and such and so forth. Okay, so we're halfway down the feet there. Okay, so now I'm going to trim its face. And same thing, I use these scissors. I get lots of comments on these long scissors, but I've tried a few over the years. But I found these are the most comfortable for me, and they work in all the areas. So I've had these same ones for over 10 years, probably even longer than that. And when I train a student, I actually, the student that I currently have, I guess you choose your own scissors, what most comfortable for you. But the student I currently have actually trained on these scissors exactly as well, so you can start with this length. It's just you have to learn the technique, so that's the most important. And because I don't use any restraints, I'm able to know when the dog is going to move, so I can respond quicker as well. I'm not relying on a restraint to hold the dog in place. So that's why they can jump quickly. Here, I know that they're gonna move because I can feel it with my other hand. A little bit of matting under his eyes, so I'm just trying to get a little bit closer. Too close. Just a little bit. But I am trimming his face up shorter, as the owner likes it shorter as well. And it looks a little bit cleaner as well, lasts a little bit longer, so the hair doesn't grow in the eyes. And if you do like this video, please check out my channel and also subscribe. Really appreciate that. And also comment and let me know what you think or if you'd like to see something different. And I'll be happy to put that on for you when I am able to do so. You never know when what a dog I'm going to be grooming or what condition they're going to be when they come. So. Very exciting. And that's why I still love it after 16 years. Plus you get to work with these cute faces. Just making sure I get it nice and clean here. And I'll be bathing him so I can come back again, but it's good to get that face done for me before the bath, because when it's wet, of course, and it looks a little bit different and dries a little bit different, but also it's really hard to blow dry their faces and their heads sometimes. So I try to take a little more effort to get that how the owner would like. Sometimes I don't get to blow dry their head and face because they don't like it at all. I don't want to stress them out any more than I have to. Alright, so I'm just going to trim the hair on the outside of the ear canal. Get that cleaned up. Of course, when trimming the ear, you always use your thumb as a guide so you know where that edge of that ear is, so you don't have to worry about accidentally trimming that. Since it's laying so nice, I'll do this ear. I'm just going to pluck out that hair. So not too much of that hair here. I'm going to turn you around, buddy. Yeah, I guess. Again, just going to trim right up to the ear canal because I don't want to accidentally pluck that hair because it is a different texture. And when you pluck the hair outside the ear, of course, it would hurt. So you always want to use the scissors or clippers for that hair. Corner here. There we go. Just a little bit in that ear as well. Now we'll work on the feet. Much as I love dog kisses right now, he's doing it because he's trying to distract me. Oh. He's like, don't do it, let me go. I know. Tough times. Hey, no. But thankfully, they're only here for an hour, so they don't get too stressed out. Yeah. He's agreeing with that. He likes that. A little bit of mats in there. Mats? You know Matt? You must know somebody named Matt. You know Matt? It's funny how some of the dogs know some P words. Most of them know they're standard, but there's some that they react to when you say. Do that when at the end. Most of them know the word walk and car ride. Treat. Gets their attention anyways and distracts them a little bit as they're trying to figure out what the heck you're talking about. You like Matt? Yeah, you like Matt. Do you know a guy named Matt? Mm-hmm. All right, so just about done here. Then I'm going to comb out his tail and give him a bath. You know that word, I bet. A little bit of fur in there. And then when he's in the tub as well, I'm just going to check his glands to see if they need to be expressed. And if they do, I will do them. And that's at the request of the owner. All right. Ready for the pub, baby? Huh? You ready? Okay, come on. Come on. Okay. Come on this way. There we go. Oh, geez. You're a cutler. Okay. And a licker. There you go. He went straight for the ear and licked me. You're so cute. You want to put that down. There we go. He's a good boy. Okay, so how you check the glands is just lift up the tail and you feel on either side of the tail to see if there's any like little round marbles, which there are. So he will need them expressed and they're pretty full, so he is not gonna like it at all and probably gonna make some noise for us. So I'm gonna put on my gloves here. He's trying to hop out into me. So I'm going to move this back a little bit so you can see him still. There you go. Larry, please stay down. Okay, so I'm just going to wet him down first. And then I'll do the glands. Paper towel as well. I have something to put the glands into. Okay, come here. Alright, like I said, they're quite full. Yeah, I know, buddy. I'm sorry. Quite full, and they may need to go to the vet, unfortunately, because it's been a little too long. Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm not going to be able to do them, so I'm going to leave them. It's okay. It's okay. Huh? There we go. I'm a dog groomer, but I am not a vet. So if it becomes too stressful for the dog, I won't do it to them. So sometimes when those glands get too full,
then obviously it's a really hard marble and the glands are a little bit fuller. So they need to, they'll do the same thing at the vet's place, but they'll have better restraints in place to hold them. But since I am by myself, I can't do that. So if I'm able to maintain it, so whenever he comes in more regularly, then they don't get so built up. And it all depends if he's been into something, like eating something he maybe he's not supposed to. Sometimes as the seasons change, you know, and there's a lot of melting and leaves and stuff that have been rotten, they'll eat that and that'll affect their digestion and that can block their glands as well. And there's a whole bunch of factors at play. Table. Get them all finished up here. I know. Here.
There you go. All right, so I'm just gonna do another round of clippers, but this time I'm gonna use a 3 3/4. That'll help give them a little bit of length since we got all those mats and thick fur off the first time. This will just clean them up and keep them as long as I can for now. But he's got lots of curls, so that's why this just takes off a little bit. Quick check of anything that maybe got missed the first time. You got lots of curl in his fur as well, but he's a bit older, so his skin is a little bit looser as well. We kind of gotta go from different angles. Be able to get it all. He wants to go this way, Okay, Mr. Larry. We've got them all here. So what I'm going to do is give them another quick blow dry without the head gear on. Try to get the head a little bit drier and see how he does. And if he doesn't like it, I will stop. And we'll go from there. Okay, ready? It up, as you can see, and I can just get that final clean. But he is ready to go home, aren't you? Yeah, you ready to go home? I know. You know this is almost time. Come on. Hey, hey. There you go. It's okay. Hey. There you go. Mr. Larry all cleaned up. We'll just touch up anything that kind of shows out of place with the scissors. Because sometimes with the clippers you can't get in all the same areas, especially when it's a longer cut. You're never going to get it all anyways. Alright, so hopefully you enjoyed the video. Like I said before, please check out and subscribe to my channel. And you can see lots more videos of how I groom dogs and how to take care of your dog and keep them looking good and feeling good. So thanks for taking the time to watch. Hope you have a great day, and I look forward to seeing you again. Bye-bye. Say bye. Ready to go home?